Hey, good morning, adventurers. Elvis Boy here. It's a beautiful Saturday morning here in Southern California, and I feel like going for a ride. So let's go see where we end up. Well, we're on the bike. Let's go. Still haven't decided where I really want to go yet. So guess we'll find out together. Beautiful day. We're heading out the 10 freeway eastbound from the Banning area, and we're passing through the Morongo Indian Reservation, where they have the casino over here, Casino Morongo. It's a good time. It doesn't get any better than this. Oh yeah, it does. All right, we're gonna stop someplace. It's one of those tourist type places that maybe some of you haven't seen before, but if you're familiar with Pee-wee's Big Adventure, his first movie, you'll recognize a couple of characters out here, and they tend to paint them up for the holidays too. So let me show you a couple of my little favorite nuggets out here in the Palm Springs area. Well, the Cabazon Dinosaurs. Pretty darn cool. Got a brontosaurus over there and a tyrannosaurus rex right there, and Pee-wee's bedroom up there in the mouth. Pretty darn cool. I'm gonna jump back on my bike and continue our journey. Okay, so hopefully everybody out there is staying healthy. I was actually supposed to do something social tonight, but my workplace, we've had a couple of cases of corona, so you know, I'm just gonna try to be good, stay away from people, social distance the best way I know how, out here on two wheels. Yeah, love social distancing. A little stop sign. There's a couple out walking their dog. Aw. And here we go. Like I said before, I hope everybody's staying healthy and making the best of this insanity that's going on around us. You know, at least the world should be ready for the zombie apocalypse anytime now. I don't think anybody would be surprised by anything at this point. So, bring it on, zombie apocalypse. Here's some of the windmills. Palm Springs is about another, you know, 5-10 miles from here. We'll be going right through it. And I think maybe I might take a little ride through Joshua Tree today. Why not? We'll see where I end up. It's kind of one of the great things about riding motorcycles. Sometimes you just get on the bike and you don't know where the heck you're going. And those are the best days. A quick fuel stop before we go into the park, because there's no fuel, no cell phone reception once you're inside the park. and there's some ups and downs that really drains your fuel. So I went past it about 4 miles to Chiraco, or Chiriaco, or however you pronounce it, Summit, to get some fuel. It's a nice place if you're traveling. This is where a lot of people buy fuel. There's a really big Chevron station with some food and a little diner. It's like a little oasis in the middle of the mountains here. That's kind of a cool place. They even have kind of an old tank museum here. Never actually stopped and checked out the vehicles in there, but there's some kind of really cool old tanks, military equipment. Chiraco Summit. It's about halfway across California, maybe 60 miles from Blythe, the border. General Patton Memorial Museum as well. Got my fuel, now I'm heading on into Joshua Tree in just a couple minutes. It's probably 5 minutes up the highway. That's some real peaceful, meditative riding through there. It's just so beautiful. Highly recommend anybody that visits Southern California take a drive through Joshua Tree. Spend the day or two there. The pass that you buy at the gate would be good for 7 days. It's $25 per vehicle. And there's more than enough things to do there for several days. All right, the road to Joshua Tree. Here we go. We're gonna stop at the Cottonwood Springs Visitor Center because I have to visit Disney's Enchanted Leaky Room before we get too deep into the park. I'll show you a couple of the kind of cool sights along the way. If you get a chance to do it on a motorcycle, highly recommend it. It's a beautiful, beautiful therapeutic ride. All right. And this adventure is keeping in theme with my channel and getting out and enjoying life and living big, putting aside your one days and your some days, and just make it a now day. Get out there and do it. So many beautiful things to do, I'm sure, in your neck of the woods. You just have to find them. I highly recommend an app called All Trails, if you're not familiar with it, to kind of let you know what's around. Adventurous. Here's the entrance to Joshua Tree National Park. It's going to be a good day and a good ride. Live big, live happy. I know I'm definitely doing that today. All right, just stopped at the visitor center to do something so that I can ride comfortably again. So off we go into the park. And at this visitor center, you can also buy passes. You can buy, I believe it's an annual pass for Joshua Tree, which I have. It's $55. And then I think for $100, you can get, I think it's called the America, the Beautiful Pass, and you can get into all of the national parks across the United States. That's what I'm going to do next time, because I plan on taking my bike and having some really cool adventures in some national parks that I've never visited before. I'd love to go on up into Zion National Park and Yellowstone and Yosemite and different places. So I'm going to plan on making some use of it, using it for some vacation time for grand adventures this coming year. 2021 is going to be fantastic compared to 2020. It can only go up or downhill or uphill. It can only get better. This has been a hell of a year. So no more thinking about negativity, man. I'm just going to enjoy this ride and enjoy this park. It's just one of those truly magical places where you feel sometimes like you're riding on another planet, because the rock formations are just so alien but beautiful. Well, these are Cholla cactuses. They're also referred to as jumping cactuses just because if you try to touch one, they have little tiny barbs on them that will just go right into your finger, as I learned one time. See if we can get over and take a walk. They're just very, very beautiful cactuses. As long as you stay away from them. Wow, just stunning. They have little flowers on them as well. Don't know if they're edible. This is what happens to them when they die, I guess. A lot of really cool trails around here. Coming up on one here, if you want, it's a couple of miles, but it's called the Arch Rock Nature Trail. And over there, amongst all of those rocks, there's a nice big arched rock formation that you can go climb up on, take some really cool pictures. And also a big rock back there that looks just like a heart that sits there. You have to kind of find it, but it's back there, and it's beautiful, man. That's a nice little area to go hiking, especially if you have kids. There's nothing real difficult. But one thing about these rocks is they're very easy to get up on and climb. They're very, very grippy, so you'll find yourself being more confident once you start stepping up on the stones and see how secure your footing is. You know, one of the things that I really like about Joshua Tree as well is they encourage you just to pull off to the side of the road anywhere. They don't care if you park on the side of the road to go explore. What I like to do is I like to find some pretty rocks that are pretty close and then pull over and go out and take a stroll. All right. Well, I parked the bike on the side of the road. And let's take a little walk. It's a great time of the day when the sun is going down and the shadows are starting to form. If you wait long enough out here, it'll all turn orange from the sunset. Then after the sun goes down, it gets real dark out here. This is a Joshua tree. Kind of a neat looking tree. And I was telling you about the rocks. And this park is pretty much like all of the rocks here are just like this. And they're very grippy. You can put your feet on the rock and pull yourself up and you won't slip. Sorry, not talking much. This is just so beautiful out here. Love it. Yeah, and this is one of those places, it's truly unlimited, the amount of adventures you can have. This isn't any kind of a special exhibit, it's just, you can pull off the road anywhere, and there's beautiful rock formations to be explored. And sometimes it's fun to kind of imagine what some of these things are, like the shapes. Your kids, if you bring them out here, they'll have fun all day climbing around on rocks. Like this one's kind of cool right here. Sort of looks like a couple of eyes, sort of, if you use your imagination. Just one of the magical spots here in Joshua Tree. Guess I'll head back to the bike and start making my way back home. So glad you came out here with me. Felt a little bit like Huell Hauser there. It's a little slice of California's gold. Well, anyway. Thanks, Huell Hauser, for kind of sort of pioneering this sort of thing, too. Getting out, exploring, and showing people the great things to do around California. And this certainly is one of them, Joshua Tree National Park. Whether you're in a car or motorcycle or in hiking boots or a bicycle, it's a bit heavenly. All right, well, that was nice. Nothing like a little hike into the desert to refresh your soul. I don't know if you could see that big rock right there. That guy standing up there on the side, on the very, very top. That's Intersection Rock right there. One of the climber's favorite places. That's one of those hell no situations for me. Jeez. All right, well, thank you for coming with me today on our tour through Joshua Tree National Park, and we stopped by Cabazon to see the dinosaurs. Well, it's really a joy to be able to do this and share a little bit of adventure with you guys and try to motivate you to get out, be positive, get out, start living life, enjoying this beautiful planet that our Creator has made for us. And that's just, if anything, you could use your social distancing to get out and explore, even by yourself or just with your family. All right, well, this is Elvis Boy for Into the Sunset. We're riding through Joshua Tree National Park. Thank you for coming along. God bless you. Please subscribe to my channel and hit the little, people call it ding dong diddle or whatever the little bell is, to let you know when I upload a new video. But it's just a joy for me, and please share my channel if you know somebody that might benefit from some motivation and or just getting out and seeing some beautiful places. I don't have too many words of wisdom today, but just get out, enjoy life, stop saying someday, one day, and just start doing it. Elvis Boy, Into the Sunset, God bless you, and I'll talk to you later. See you next time. The red-nosed reindeer had a very shiny nose, and if you ever saw it, you would even say it glows. All of the other reindeers used to laugh and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer games. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, "Rudolph, with your nose so bright,
won't you guide my sleigh tonight?
Then all the reindeers loved him, and they shouted out with glee, yay! Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, he'll go down in history. Happy holidays, everybody.